As you saw in the previous chapter, processed signals represent the impact of NGF. If a processed signal is near zero, it indicates no change from the control, while a positive number does up-regulation, and a negative number does down-regulation. It may be more understandable if you show the control groups. You can create a dataset displaying the control groups. Again, as you saw in the previous chapter, you selected these four flag columns for use in the filtering later. Before you open the filter tool, take a look at the all samples dataset to remind the number of samples in each group. You see the breakdown of each group. The control groups have a variation in the number of samples. There is only one sample in the control 2-hour group because one of the duplicates has a quality issue, and you decided to exclude it. Now open the filter tool. First, you check for genes that are flagged in the G as feet non-UNIF OL column, meaning outlier. Similarly, check for genes that are flagged in the GISBG non-UNIF OL, also meaning outlier. You detected genes with abnormal measurements by this filtering. Though you exclude such genes with outliers from the analysis, there may be interesting genes. So, save them to check separately. Now you create the QC1 list by excluding the genes with outlier values. The next step is to apply a filter to the QC1 list. If G is well above BG is flagged, the measurement is sufficiently higher than the detection limit, and the measurement value is trustworthy. Conversely, look at the genes which G is well above BG is zero in at least one sample. You can also apply this filter to a specific sample. Notice that the boundary differs from sample to sample. If you set a dataset containing merged groups, the filter evaluates per group, not per sample. When you set the average dataset, the three groups of NGF processes are evaluated with average 2, the number of groups is 6, including control. A setting like passing more than 100% samples in 6/6 sample groups is the same as simply evaluating all samples. You can set the filter in a more sophisticated way. For example, let's change it to passing more than 50% samples. If you don't have reliable measurements in more than half of the samples in all groups, you can't rely on the group averages. You can safely exclude more genes for more reliable subsequent analysis than with a simple filter. Let's call this the QC2 list. Cumulatively, we do filtering against the QC2 list on the processed signal. Collect genes which mean of processed signals are ranged from -1 to 1 in all groups. By this filtering, there are only 5,720 genes left for the subsequent analysis. Set the vertical axis of scatter plot view to display the processed signal so that you determine the threshold. If you regard a range of -0.5 to 0.5 as not changing, more than 20,000 genes pass the filter. With this setting, you can see that you can leave not only low expression regions but also genes in high expression regions. You can fine-tune it as seeing the number of filter passing genes. The purpose of the analysis and the spec of your computer affect determining the threshold. Remove the genes with no expression variation and save the QC3 list. The following analysis is only for the genes in the QC3 list. Extract genes that are up or down regulated by NGF treatment from the QC3 list. The Compareto control tool is for detecting DEGs in the specified sample group, which you drag M-drop from the sample group section in the left panel. You can arbitrarily set the threshold of the fold difference and p-value. Here, we extract genes whose expression levels were altered after 8 hours of the NGF treatment. Save the list of DEGs. Next, try the Compare Two Groups tool. The difference from the previous tool is that you have to set two sample groups to calculate, which are the control and NGF groups in this case. The thresholds for the fold difference and p-value are the same as before, though the test method is not same. Save the DEGs list. Compare the two DEG lists from the two tools, or two test methods, with the Venn diagram tool. The DEGs are mostly common, though, about a quarter of them are unique to each method. You can't say which one is more accurate. The number of samples violates the assumption of statistical test anyway. The number of replicates in control varies, while that in NGF treated is constant. So, if you want to compare lists among the time points, the Compare to Control tool is a better choice. Let's extract DEGs in the 2-hour group from the QC3 list. Create a folder to indicate that you have extracted from the QC3 list, store the list in that folder. Save the DEG lists in the 8-hour group. Save the DEG lists in the 24-hour group. Thus, you have the 6 up and down lists at each time point. Use the Venn diagram tool to compare the up lists at 2, 8, and 24 hours. Between adjacent time points, such as 2 hours and 8 hours, or 8 hours and 24 hours, you find some commonly elevated genes. However, there are few genes in common in other combinations. Let's try to compare the down lists next. Like the result from comparing the up lists, you find some commonly reduced genes at 2 hours and 8 hours. However, few genes are commonly reduced in 8 and 24 hours. Next, let's compare between the different time points with the Compare Two Groups tool. Extract DEGs between 2 and 8 hours. And extract DEGs between 8 and 24 hours. Now you have lists of genes in which the NGF effect varies between adjacent time points. Create the union of all DEG lists. But, you can't compare more than three lists in the Venn diagram tab. So, switch to the hashtag overlaps tab that accepts any number of measurement lists. You can create a list by specifying the number of overlaps. For example, you can create the union of the 10 lists by setting greater than equals 1 and less than equals 10. By the way, if you set greater than equals 10 and less than equals 10, you get the intersection of all lists. There is no gene in this case. These lists are mostly independent of each other. There are only a few common genes. One way to test the concordance of the DEGs is to look at other researchers' experimental data. Right-click on a cell in the table of the Annotations tab, you can copy the text in that cell. For example, let's copy and paste the gene names into the search field of the Geo database. In the search result for the geo profiles, you see what treatments can cause the alteration in the expression levels, and in what type of cells. If you have the system plugin, you can do the same kind of search against data sets that you have analyzed before and stored in the Subio platform.